If you're using PHP and you have a problem with the installation of this software, the one we're going to talk about here is how to install intl extension in Ubuntu. So we're going to be using Ubuntu now, so to install that software. And the software is pretty important because you cannot do some major things. The reason why I'm installing here is that I had a problem with installing Moodle on my PC. So I'm using Ubuntu. So there was no way I was gonna put Moodle instead of up until when I have to fix this. So once you fix that, then everything's gonna be cool for you. You get me? So there are many ways how to do that, but I used only this line. But first of all, you have to upgrade your system after updating with using apt-get update. Then after updating, then you can run this. But also, it depends on which kind of version you're using of PHP. So to see the version of PHP, you say PHP minus V, then you say enter. When you do that, it's gonna give you that you're using 7.4 or 7.3 or 5 point something. Then after doing that, you're gonna be able to know which version you're using. So after that, then you're gonna be able to to install the software I'm going to show you. Okay, let's go in the video, then we carry on doing stuff. Okay guys, let's proceed. Proceeding to the video. Hi, I'm gonna show you how to fix this problem. I was installing modem, so then after that I ran into some problems here where it says Intel extension requires to improve internationalization support, such as locale aware sorting and international domain names. So what they say, we have to install now this software. So that what it tells you. So no, that's good. Okay. And okay. Also here they tell us some problems here, but let's try to. They say they need another DB here, but let's try to fix this first. Okay. So I've got some. One of the codes I can use for now. And see if it will work for us. If it doesn't, then we're gonna find something else. So let me try to do this first. We're gonna do this. Okay, but then we have to say sudo. First of all, we have to update. I'm gonna say apt-get. Then update. We're gonna update our system first, and then after that we can do that. We can install then the software we have to install. So let's update and see. Still updating. Okay, it's done. So after doing that, we're going to install our package. Then we say yes. Ubuntu 7.4. PHP, we have 7. PHP 7.4, that's what we have. So it's done. It tells us that it's done. We're gonna say service, please restart. We're gonna restart our service. Restart Apache. We're gonna say Apache 2. So let's see. There's no service like that. I think I did misspell this. Patch 2. Okay, restart service. Okay, I think I'm forgetting something. Let me get here. Service. Okay, we have to say service Apache to restart. So that's where I made a mistake. So I'm gonna copy this. It's good sometimes to document your tutorial. Becomes a little bit easier for people even are watching. Okay, we restarted that. After that, then we're gonna do refresh here and see if we can see this problem anymore. Okay. Wow, that problem is gone. Thank God we're done with that problem. So that's the way to fix that, and it's the same tutorial which gonna help you to install that software, the one we say in the prompt. So here we're gonna have a lot of things to do before we proceed, because we're gonna have we remain with two problems here. One is MySQL full Unicode support F.what file, your database uses Antelope as the file. So now they want us to change to UTF, you get me? So if we change to UTF, then that's gonna be 100% fine, you get me? So I'm installing model, that's why I'm seeing this problem. So whoever is installing this, if you're using Ubuntu or Linux, any kind of Linux, you might find yourself into a problem like this. So also we have what they call MySQL Unicode support large prefix. For full support of UTF-8, both MySQL and MariaDB requires you to change your MySQL settings in DB large prefix to on. Okay, see the documentation here. So they talk about the documentation here. They say check, but you cannot check that. So guys, if you're facing the first problem, good enough, we fixed it. These problems, like whenever you see this, the yellow thing, it's gonna be something which we can do go on with, because these are warnings. And here up we only have one warning, two warnings. Warnings in most cases they don't stop a software to work, but they emphasize on trying to do what they want you to do. Okay, if you've seen what we've done and it didn't work for you, the installation goes like this. You have to install, then you restart your Apache server. First of all, you didn't see us putting a sudo keyword. You must put a sudo keyword on the in the beginning of the what of this, you get me? So it's not necessarily that you have to use the line which I used. You can also use this line based on the version of PHP you are using. So you can see this one, you can just put PHP 7.4.4, because that's what I used. But I'm using, I didn't use that, I just used this universal one so that everyone can try to use that. But if it doesn't work, then what you got to do is to put your PHP dot PHP 7 dot what. Is it a version 7? How do you check the version? Let me try to say v minus PHP, let's see, PHP version. Okay, sometimes the commands you lose them. PHP minus v. Okay, you can see if you put PHP minus v, this one, it can give you the version of your PHP you are using, you get me? So now what you do, you're going to take that version. You don't take the three, you take the first two numbers and then put it on. Let me show you. You put it here. Where is you're gonna put it on here. After you say php intl, you just php 7.4. if yours is three, you put a three. If it's one, you put a one dash, then you put the software you want to install, you get me? So once that is done, it's gonna work proper. But also don't forget the first line I did was to update. Update your system first, be sudo. You can see this hashtag means that I'm sudo. After being sudo, then it's gonna be easier for you to do stuff well, you get me? So if you are sudo, it means you have powers to do all those changes, guys. So that's the way to overcome that error. And you saw the error, what it says. It was saying that intl extension is required to improve internationalization support, such as locale, away, whatever. So if you go to Google, even you can find this this error, because this error is not for you only, it happens to many people based on the software you're trying to install. So if let's go to Google, let me see. I said Google. Say to google.com. Okay, if I go to google.com and I say okay, you can see module 17 whatever, and there are many people have done some videos about this. If mine did not help you, you can try to go to other videos, but I hope this helps you guys, because I've done it and you've seen that the problem was being fixed. You can see this has 36,000 results, you get me? So which is a bit of a problem to people. So that's why you try to say that, please, if it didn't work, try to tell us what went wrong. So you can see the same software here, module, is the one gets a problem to people, giving many people problems, you get me? So guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. This is Azania Tutorials, guys. I wanna get okay.